You know, I've been wanting to get more information on this story because, frankly, it's irritating to read something like this just as we're telling you and have been following the very latest out of Iraq as we learn that our troops are getting out and Operation New Dawn begins, where our guys are going to be there doing some training and advisory roles. But now we hear two Americans are dead and nine are wounded. They were shot at. Get this. This is the part of the story that we find most interesting. An Iraqi soldier shoots at U.S. soldiers in northern Iraq. Now, as I read this, obviously the thoughts that come to my mind is Iraqi soldiers, wait, they're supposed to be on our side. We're supposed to be fighting together. Why would an Iraqi soldier be turning on U.S. soldiers? Barbara Starr is joining us now. She's got more details from the Pentagon. Barbara, what's going on here?
Well, Rick, tragically, we don't know the answer about why this Iraqi soldier in particular did what he is now alleged to have done. It has happened before, both in Iraq and Afghanistan. This time, an Iraqi soldier opened fire on American troops at a base in northern Iraq, killing two Americans and wounding nine others. This, of course, is the first instance of Americans dying in Iraq after the combat mission ended last week. By all accounts, the Iraqi soldier pulled his weapon, fired at the Americans, killing two, wounding nine before he was shot. And, you know, basically what this comes down to is what any soldier will tell you on the ground in Iraq. The combat mission may have ended on the part of the politicians, combat on the part of the troops.
Yeah, but it goes beyond this. I mean, when you really think about this, it's the ultimate act of betrayal. I can understand that our enemy is going to be shooting at our guys. I can't understand that the people that we're training to protect this country, and when we eventually leave, are shooting at our guys. I mean, the whole thing for Americans who are paid into this war with blood and sacrifice and our treasure have to be looking at this and going, what?
Well, certainly. I mean, and that's why I would remind people this has happened in both wars before, where local Afghan troops, local Iraqi troops have done this. You know, what can you say? They will investigate, they will find out what this man's motivations were, why he did it, and troops do everything they can, American troops, to protect themselves.
But one of the biggest problems, right, that they've had in Iraq, and in Afghanistan for that matter, is trying to find the right people who truly are, who are true to the cause. What does this say about that effort to try and create a police force, an army?
Yeah, I mean, this is one of the crucial challenges in both of these wars, to find the Iraqi troops and the Afghan troops that are loyal to their government and loyal to what is going on, that aren't perhaps, you know, behind the scenes insurgents, more loyal to the insurgents than they are to their own governments. And in some cases, that is what has happened in some of these past instances. These people have proven to be corrupt, and it's something that is a huge challenge in both war zones, to make sure the security forces are not actually more loyal to the insurgencies.
What a story. We're going to have more as we drill down on this tonight at 8 p.m. on the primetime edition of Rick's List. My thanks to Barbara Starr for bringing us up to date on this story. And obviously, if anything else develops on this, we will bring it to you as well.
In Iraq, U.S. soldiers came under fire today in two attacks, one of them deadly. CNN's Arwa Damon is in Baghdad. Arwa.
Wolf, a week after the U.S. military officially ended its combat role in Iraq, at least two U.S. soldiers were killed, another 10 wounded in two separate attacks, both in the same province. The deadliest and more disturbing happening on an Iraqi army military base where a U.S. captain had a meeting. The soldiers escorting him were waiting outside when they got into some sort of an argument with an Iraqi army soldier. That's according to the spokesman for Iraq's Minister of Defense. The soldier pulled out his weapons and shot at the soldiers, killing at least two Americans, wounding another nine. The other incident happening in Tikrit at the center of the city, where a convoy came under grenade attack. The U.S. says that they shot and killed the attacker, but that one U.S. soldier was wounded and another three civilians were wounded as well when one of those grenades exploded. This is very much a reminder that even though Operation Iraqi Freedom, the combat mission here, may have come to an end, we may be entering the era of Operation New Dawn that is supposed to be seeing the Americans in a non-combat role. Iraq still very much remains a deadly battleground. Wolf?